This is Brampton Focus. My name is Michael A. Charbon. Continuing with our one-on-one discussion with the newly elected mayor of Brampton, Mr. Patrick Brown. Thank you for your time. I appreciate that. I know you've got lots of meetings scheduled, so we appreciate your time. Let's continue our discussion. One of the things that has come up now, and the premier has talked about this, is amalgamation. We know once the region of Peel reaches 1 million, it's going to be the city of Peel. And amalgamation is one of those things that's a contentious issue. Where do you sit on that, and how do you see Brampton positioning itself? I mean, Mayor Crombie has talked about her own city-state, if you wish, outside of that.
So the Premier has not actually used the words amalgamation. He has said he's going to look at regional governance review. There are regional governments in the province that he wants to look at whether they still serve the purpose. I would note that the option favored by Hazel McCallion is to get rid of the region. It's not a merger. The position of Bonnie Crombie is not amalgamation. It's that the services of the region be downloaded to municipalities to run as a single tier. Listen, if it's not broken, don't fix it. My immediate reaction to this announcement was I have more pressing concerns for the province to spend their time and energy on. I've got hallway medicine within healthcare in Brampton. We've got the mess that they've created on the GO train. We've got the need for post-secondary education. I wish the province would dedicate some time to that, but if this is their priority, I'll welcome looking at the region, making sure that there's no duplication. Right now, the region runs our police, they run our waste management. There are some services that, frankly,
fire is
local. If you look at the police and waste management, we get efficiencies. Our dollar goes further by pooling those costs with entire region. And so, I welcome the review. But I'd stress this is not our top priority. My top priority is the issues that residents talk about to me daily. Hallway medicine, the GO Transit mess, traffic, gridlock, jobs. That's what I want to work on. That's what I want the province to work on.
You talked about GO Train. Give us an update on the schedule. There was an announcement that just happened, which was not really well received, as one would say.
So I don't know what Metrolinx in the province was thinking. When they canceled the express train in the afternoon during rush hour, obviously, the videos have gone viral over the overcrowding on the platforms and the trains. It's thrown people's schedules into chaos. It's been commuter chaos. Now, give the minister credit. Jeff Urich responded to my official complaint, has said that they're going to address this, has said they're going to fix it. It's only been 2 weeks now, so it's still rather
fresh.
This can't be something that we wait months for. This needs to be fixed in a matter of days. I am growing increasingly impatient over their blunder. It's one thing to make a mistake. Everyone makes mistakes. The government made a mistake here with the schedule change. Mm-hmm. But real leadership is correcting the mistake. They've said they will, and now they have a time to do it, and we're watching.
With the approval of cannabis sale here in Brampton, which was recently approved by council, you were always a supporter of the police. You're pro-police. You want to see more police. You want to see more services. Jennifer Evans, we had the opportunity at Brampton Focus to do one of only two exit interviews that she did. I had the opportunity to sit down and speak to Chief Evans. When you look at how the process is going to be work now to find the next police chief of the Peel region, and when you see extra resources for Brampton, what's your take on that? What's your snapshot?
So I'm pro public safety, which I think we all are. I want to have zero tolerance on crime in our community to the best of our abilities. There's always going to be some idiot, and I want to make sure when there's someone that breaks our trust, our laws, that we have deterrence, that they're made an example of, that conduct is not tolerated. And the fact that we've had a number of homicides this year is worrisome. Mm-hmm. It's why we've pushed in our budget to increase the number of police officers. But I don't think the solution is as simplistic as simply more officers. We need better mental health programs. The COAST program with the police is integral. I want to have investments in recreation, in culture, to positive diversions. You need to have a community that gets young people off the street. And so there is no magic bullet. But I would say selecting a new chief is an opportunity to bring fresh ideas into public safety in Peel Region. We haven't received applications yet. So I'm not going to prejudge the process as, mm-hmm. as I sit as a member of the Police Services Board,
right.
But I know there's going to be a number of talented applications, and I'm looking forward to see what leading lights from around the country put their names in to be our next chief of police.
In this time in Brampton, there's been a huge influx of new talent. And one would say junior politicians, never done it before. In the same way, there are many of those that are on the region. And they sit on the region looking out for the benefits mm-hmm. of Brampton. When you sit now on the region with all these new faces, these fresh ideas, how do you see the future panning out for Brampton? It's always been a point that they haven't had the same amount of votes that would necessarily mm-hmm. represent the population. Where do you see that going in the next little while?
So that regional governance file is part of the review that the Premier announced of the regions, and that will get looked at. But honestly, that's not my biggest priority. Would I like Brampton to have a larger say of on the region appeal governing body? Of course, but that is behind my immediate need as mayor of the city to have our hallway medicine addressed, to have our gridlock addressed, to have our need for industry addressed. But in terms of how I feel about Brampton going forward, I'm optimistic. I know we have the tools here. I know we have the ingredients here to make Brampton a spectacular city that's the envy of Ontario. And I look at the team. You know, you could be elected mayor and you have to work with your team. I got a great team here. Let me say the staff at City Hall, I've been increasingly impressed with. We've got some real energy. Our council, we've got some real talent on City Council. We got a really impressive team around the table, and so as mayor of the city, I'm pretty optimistic about the years ahead, and I that's why I said at the beginning of this interview, I get excited to go to work every day.
And if you were to look into the crystal ball, here we are coming up to a federal election. This area is highly liberal, but it's changed from liberal to conservative, etc. With the federal election coming up, what type of a relationship are you going to have with your MPs in this area to make sure, from a federal standpoint, that Brampton receives the support and the funding that it needs?
Listen, I don't care if it's red, orange, or green. I don't care if it's conservative or liberal. For me, it's about who will deliver for the city of Brampton. I know Andrew Scheer. I've served with him in Ottawa. I've had some very productive conversations with Prime Minister Trudeau.
Sat across from him when you were a member in Barrie, for goodness sakes.
Yeah, and Prime Minister Trudeau has reached out when I was elected. And so I think all the parties understand that if they want to win, they need to win seats in Brampton, and they better deliver. Brampton better be on their radar. Brampton better be part of their agenda. We have major needs in this city that haven't been met, and not just by the current government, by consecutive governments, both provincially and federally, of different partisan stripes. The city's been ignored for a long time. Our health care is worse than other cities. Our transit is crumbling compared to other cities, and I'm not going to sit by quietly and have the city ignored. We're going to stand up for ourselves. We're going to tell the Prime Minister and the Premier we expect Brampton to get its fair share.
Patrick Brown, the Mayor of Brampton. You've been watching Brampton Focus. My name is Michael A. Charbon. Thanks for watching.